Do you know why I sing Russian slander before never met?
Why is that?
That's a man of the victory. Song of the victory, because Russia never lost the war.
Nikolai Volkov wasn't Russian. Come on, it is pro wrestling. But the man he was in real life is why being the Russian villain was so important. His name was Josip Perusevich. He was born in Croatia. Croatia was still part of Yugoslavia, a virtual satellite state of the Soviet Union. It was through sports that Josip would make his escape. At 20 years old, Josip defected during a weightlifting competition. He ended up in Canada. That's where he discovered pro wrestling. He then came to the United States with just $50 in his pocket and one suit to his name. His skill in the ring would fix that, and it also would bring Josip a new identity.
He is from Mongolia, Nikolai Volkov!
That's right, Nikolai was from Mongolia, and he would be until the 1980s. In the news, tension between the U.S. and the Soviet Union, and in the wrestling world, a new hometown for Nikolai Volkov and a new mission to drive fans absolutely berserk.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Volkov requests that you all rise and respect his singing of the Soviet national anthem.
Volkov was reluctant to play a communist. He did survive the Yugoslav dictatorship, after all. But his on-screen manager, Classy Freddie Blassie, convinced Nikolai that the best way to fight communism was to make fun of it. And no one did it better. Volkov and his partner in America hating, the Iron Sheik, couldn't go anywhere in public without a disguise. When the Cold War ended, Nikolai Volkov finally got to show off the love he had for the USA in real life. He lived out his years in Baltimore. That's where his wife found him unresponsive on Sunday. He was 70 years old. Whenever he traveled to wrestling conventions, or if you just happened to see him in public, Nikolai Volkov would happily bust out the Soviet national anthem for you if you wanted. But there was another song that he liked to sing just a little bit more. And so we say do svidaniya to possibly the best friendly neighborhood villain this country ever had. Ray Steele, RTV6.